Welcome. In this video, we walk through training your own AI model for medical imaging segmentation using MONAI. This guide was made by a dummy for dummies. Good luck. I will start by discussing the minimum requirements. At least 8 gigabytes of RAM, preferably more, 20 gigabytes of free hard disk storage, and optionally a CUDA-enabled NVIDIA GPU. The GPU helps tremendously with training speed. The tools I will use in this video are Docker to easily manage all dependencies and environments, WSL2 or Windows Subsystems for Linux that lets us run Linux tools on Windows, the NVIDIA Container Toolkit, which is required for GPU support in Docker, and Slicer 3D, a powerful medical imaging tool with MONAI Label integration. In this video, I use a publicly available dataset from Kaggle. It's the medical segmentation decathlon for the heart. It includes 20 CT images of the heart and their corresponding labels of the left atrium for training. It contains an additional 10 images for testing. We begin with installing Slicer 3D from slicer.org. There's different versions available, but we will download the version for Windows since that is what this tutorial is made for. After the file is downloaded, we can install Slicer. After Slicer is installed, we open Slicer to install two extensions. Within the extension manager, we can look for new extensions. In this case, we're looking for the MONAI extensions. These are MONAI Label and MONAI Auto 3D Seg. We can install them through the manager as well. In order for these extensions to work, we need to restart Slicer. And then we see that the extensions become available within the Slicer environment. Next is the Docker installation. We download Docker from docker.com. Docker allows us to run MONAI inside containers. These are portable, consistent environments with all the necessary libraries already installed, saving a lot of hassle compared to, for example, running MONAI through Python. after installing Docker, we quickly have to log in and we can fill in the reasons why we use it. You can also choose to skip this option. Then we install WSL2. To install WSL2, we Google WSL install for Windows, and we will get to the page of Windows itself, how we install WSL. WSL is installed through command prompt. So we start command prompt and we run the code WSL --install. It will then start installing WSL. After installing WSL, we can start installing the NVIDIA Container Toolkit, necessary to enable GPU support. When first attempting to retrieve the Container Toolkit from GitHub, I get the error "no valid OpenPGP data found." This error shows due to the fact that WSL cannot connect to the internet. If we ping Google, we can see that it doesn't work. In order to resolve the network issues, we have to set a DNS server, and in this case we specify it to the DNS 8.8.8.8. This is a public DNS server run by Google, which is popular because it's fast, reliable and widely accessible. After setting the DNS, we rerun the Google ping and we can see that it gives us a ping time, which means the internet connection now works. We then continue running our codes for installing NVIDIA Toolkit. We then continue installing our code from the NVIDIA Toolkit install guide, where we configure the production repository, we update the package list, and we install the toolkit. Next, we have to download the apps that we will use to train our model from GitHub. We first make a working directory, we set our working directory, and we then put in the code to clone the apps from GitHub to our working folder. After that, we set our working directory to the folder where we can find the app that we will use. This will be the segmentation app in the radiology folder. A quick test run will show that we can now run our server with the correct app. Press Ctrl C to close the server at the end. After we have set our working directory, we'll need to configure our model the way we want to use it. So we go to the config folder in the radiology library. We go to the segmentation model, which is the model that I will be using since it's easiest to use. And in that segmentation model that we open in any type of Pi editor, in my case PyCharm, in the configuration file for the segmentation app, we can see that it's currently looking for a lot of different segmentations. In this example, we are only looking to do the left atrium. So we delete everything we don't use, and we change the name of the first to left atrium. Furthermore, we set the use pre-trained model to false. After adjusting our configuration, we can get our data ready. We put the data that we have collected in the MONAI server, .data. I use the .nii files from the folder that I previously downloaded. After we put our data in place, we run our code to start the server. The server then takes a second to start, and once it's started, we can open Slicer. In Slicer, we need to connect Slicer to the server. To do this, we set our MONAI label server to the 8001 address as specified in the code I've used to run our server. By pressing next sample, I get the first random sample from our data set. In the options, we can set the model we can train. We can change the name to left atrium, and we do not want it pre-trained. There's more settings you can play with. In segmentation, we can now see we are looking for a label just for the left atrium. All the way at the bottom of this field, in tools, we can find our label. I get a little bit lost, but once we've retrieved the label, we can open it by pressing the download or upload button, and then we can see how the label fits over our CT. We then do this a couple more times to give our model more data to work with. Next, I'll show you how you can alter your label or completely make your own label. In this case, we just altered the label a little bit. If you want to know how to make your own label or further work with the segmenter, there are lots of online tutorials available for Slicer where they teach you how to segment. In this example, I will only erase a little bit of the label to then repair it back. We again submit the label to the server, and after we have given the server enough data to work with, we can start training our model. We press the button train, and in our WSL environment, we can now see that it's training the model. Depending on your GPU, you will have different speeds. Also, depending on the amount of epochs that you're running, in this case 50, you can get better or lower accuracy. The accuracy that Slicer shows is due to the fact that out of every 5 data imaging that you, out of every 5 data points that you submit, so matched, label, and image, it will take 1 to test it on and see how close it is to the label that you have uploaded. Next, we can load a new sample to see how our model works. In the auto segmentation tab, we use the segmentation model because that is the model that we've been training, and we run it. We can then see in WSL that it's using the model. Then we can see how it fits over the CT we made, and we can see it in 3D. In the segmentation folder, the model that we've been working with, we now have a map left atrium, the name that we have given it in Slicer 3D. Here we can find all our information of our model. Congratulations! You have now trained your own medical imaging segmentation model. MONAI also offers other AI imaging solutions, for example, Vista2D, in which they can use the model to automatically segment imagery of cells. I hope this has inspired you to further use MONAI to speed up research, whether this is medical or in any other field.